Now we'll see the traveling salesperson problem using the branch and bound technique. Okay, so normally what do you mean by the traveling salesperson problem? So traveling salesperson problem is nothing but, so we have to obtain the cheapest round trip, okay, such that each city is visited exactly once and then returning to the starting city, then only the tour will be complete. For example, if you start with one particular node, okay, so we have to visit all the nodes which is present there exactly once, and finally it reached to the starting node. Okay, so that will be the traveling salesperson problem. Okay, so now I told you for this branch and bound, so this technique is used to solve the optimization problem. So in the traveling salesperson problem, so we have to find the least cost. Otherwise, if you are considering as the distance means, that is you have to consider the least distance. So here this problem will be the minimization problem. So you have to find the lower bound value for this particular problem. Okay, so to find the lower bound value, so what we have to do, so finding the smallest element in the intercity distance matrix D and multiplying it by the number of cities n. Okay, so this will be the graph they are given. So for this graph, what A, B, C, D, E means, so this will be the city. Okay, so now we have to find the smallest element in the intercity distance. So here they are considering as the distance. So now if you want to travel the city A to B, the distance will be 3. Okay, so this graph is an undirected graph. So A to B also the distance is 3, and B to A also the distance is 3. Okay, so now here what happened? So A to C we are having the distance 1, and A to D we are having the distance 5, and A to E we are having the distance 8. Okay, so to find the lower bound, finding the smallest element in the intercity distance D, we have to find the smallest element in the intercity distance D. Okay, so here, so for each city, for each and every city, the city should be starts from 1 to n. Okay, find the sum SI of the distance from city I to the two nearest cities. Okay, so here I am taking the city A. So from the city A, you have to consider the two nearest city. So here that is we are having the edges 1, 3, 5 and 8. So two smallest nearest city means, so A to C is one city with the smallest value, and A to B will be the nearest city with the value 3. So compute the sum S of this n numbers, divide the result by 2. If all the distances are integer, round up the results to the nearest integer. So to find the lower bound value, so what you have to do? So you have to consider all the cities. Okay, from each and every city, you have to take the two nearest cities. Okay, and then that has to be divided by 2. So finally, it has to be round up to the integer. Okay, so now the formula to find the lower bound value, LB is equal to, so this ceiling function you will take, the ceiling function S divided by 2. Okay, so now this is the graph we are taken. Okay, so in the graph, so what we have to do, now we have to find the lower bound value. So I am considering the value A. Okay, so if I am considering the city A means, so here that is we have to consider the two nearest value. Okay, that is 1 and 3 we are taken. So I am taking that is 1 plus 3. Okay, now I am considering the city B. So if you are considering the city B, here we are having 4 values, 3, 6, 7 and 9. So I am taking two nearest city, that is I am taking 3 and 6. So 3 plus 6. If I am taking the C, so the C we are having 1, 2, 4 and 8. Okay, so I am taking 1 and 2. Okay, so now here that is if you are considering the D means, here we are having 3, 4, 5 and 7. So I am taking 3 and 4. Okay. If I am taking this E means 2, 3, 8, 9. So I am considering that is 2, 1, 3. Okay. So now you add everything. That is 3 plus 2, 5, 5, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15, 21, 24, 25, 26, 28. On 28 divided by 2, that is we are having the value 14. So now the lower bound value for this particular problem will be 14. Okay. So now whatever the solution we are getting, the solution will not be minimum than this lower bound value. It should be the equal to 14 or it should be greater than this 14. Okay. So here to reduce the amount of the potential workup. So two observation we are considering. Okay. So I told you that is we have to consider everything. Okay, in the assignment problem, what I told, so I am taking that is A is equal to 1, A is equal to 2, A is equal to 3, A is equal to 4. We are considering everything and then from there we are starting. Okay, but here what you have to do is to reduce the amount of potential work. So what you have to do, so we are removing some nodes. Okay, so now without the loss of generality, so we have to consider the tour that starts with the vertex A. So now here the starting vertex we are considering that is A. Okay. So because of the graph is undirected, so generate only tours in which B is visited before C. Okay. So even though it's an undirected graph, so what we have to do, so we are considering that is tour B is visited before that C. Okay. So that I will explain you in the problem. Okay. So in addition to that, after visiting the four cities, a tour has no choice but to visit to the remaining unvisited city and returns to the starting one. Okay. So we here what happened, if we are having that is the n vertex, means the tour has to visit all the n vertices and again it has to reach to the starting vertex. Okay. So here that is we are using the state space tree techniques for solving the traveling salesperson problem. So normally the state space tree techniques that enable us to solve the many large instances of the different combinatorial problem. So whatever the combinatorial problem we are having, or the problem is having the large instance, so we can try to solve that problem using the state space tree techniques. Okay. So now you consider this. Okay, this is a state space tree. So initially this will be the lower bound value. So the lower bound value that is I am taking that is 14. Okay, so here I am taking. So the number I mentioned here, no. So this will be the way in which way we are doing. Okay, and then the starting vertex we are taking as A. Okay, so from A that is we have to visit this B. And from A we can visit C, or from A we can visit D, or from A we can visit E. Okay. So all four possibilities are there. Okay. So now what we have to do. So here first you consider that is A to B. Okay. So if you want to go to A to B means, so A to B what value we are having. So that value you have to consider. Okay. And then the next lowest value. Okay. So here anyway, this will be the lowest value. So there will be no changes. So A to B if you are having. So first you consider this 3 and then the one least value, that is 3 plus 1 we are taken. Okay, so 3 plus 1. And then B if you are taken, and then if you are taking B, again that is this is undirected. So B to A also, that is the same value. So that is 3 you have to take. So next smallest value, that will be 6. So this will be 3 plus 6. Again C, there will be no changes, 1 plus 2. Because here we have to concentrate only on the AB. So we have to consider two edges. AB also you have to consider. At the same time, you have to consider that BA. Okay. So now A we have to consider and B you have to consider, because here the rally will be remain same. So C will be the same value, 1 plus 2, 3 plus 4, 2 plus 3. So the value will be, so if you add this, this will be the value will be 14. So here we are having this 14. So here I am calculated that. Okay. So now, so if you are taken that is A to C. So if A to C means you have to consider the value A to C. Okay, so now that is A to C, the value is already we are considering in this part also, we are considering in this part also, we are considering. Okay, so I'll explain the next one. Okay, so now the value will be 14 for A to C. Okay, so now if you are having that is A to D, so A to D if you are considering, you see, so first we are taking this is the A vertex. If you are taking the A vertex, what will happen? So normally you will take the one value and then the three values. So because this will be the two smallest value. Okay. But here we are traveling from A to D. So this value will be taken. That is A to D, what value we are taken. So that value will be taken. And then we have to consider the lowest value. So 5 we have to take. Then 5 plus 1 we have to take. Okay. So 5 plus 1 we have to consider. So see here A to D, that is 5 plus 1 we have to consider. Okay. So now the B means there is no change because we have to consider only A and D or D to A. Okay, so B will be remain same 3 plus 6, and C will be remain same 1 plus 2. Okay, when it comes to the D part, so initially the D we are having 3 plus 4, but now that is we are having D to A, that value is fixed, that is 4, that 5. So this value you have to take, and then you have to consider the next smallest value. So we have to take 5 plus 3. Okay, so here that is we are having 5 plus 3 plus this will be remain same 2 plus 3 divided by 2, that is the value we are having 16. Okay, so same way we have to consider for A to E. So if you are taking that is A to E means here we are having A to E, that is we are having the value 8. So this 8 you have to consider, this 1 you have to consider. So 8 plus 1 9. Okay, so now B will be remain same, and C will be remain same, and D will be remain same. Okay, next if it comes to 8, sorry E, here 8 plus 2, so 8 plus 2, that is we are having, that is 10. So first we are having 9 and next we are having 10 plus this 3 we have to add. Okay, so here that is 8 plus 1 and then 9 plus 2. See here, so 8 plus 1 we are having, this will be remain same. Okay, and then 8 plus 2 we are having, so the value will be 19. So now if you want to travel from A to B, the distance will be 14. If you want to travel from A to C, distance will be 14. A to D, distance will be 16. A to E, distance will be 19. So we are having 14, 14, 16 and 19. So 14, 14, 16 and 19. Okay. So here out of this 4 value, so we have to consider this 2 value. Either we can travel from A to B or we can travel from A to C. Okay, so I told in this problem, without the loss of generality, we are considering the tour that starts with vertex A. Okay, so because of the graph is the undirected graph, so we have to generate the tours in which B is visited before C. Now, normally, if you want to break the timings, we have to go in alphabetical order. No, so if you are considering that is B and C, both are having the same value, so I am starting from the B. So if you want to go, you can also consider this value and then you can come out with the results. Okay, so to reduce the potential work, so I am taking that as a B. Okay, so now what happened? Now we have started with the vertex A. So from the vertex A, we are visited the vertex B. So from B, whether we have to visit C or D or E, that we have to consider. Okay, so from B, we have to check whether we have to visit the vertex C or visit the vertex D or visit the vertex E. Okay, so now you have to consider this BC. Here you have to consider this BD. Here you have to consider this BE. Okay, so you have to find that BC, BD and then BE. Okay, so here what happened? Same thing. The A value, D value, E value will not change. So only the value change will be B and then C according to the edges. So here you have to change the value, that is B and D. Here you have to change the value B and A. Okay, so now we found the value, that is 16, 16 and 19. Okay, so 16, 16 and 19, here that is we are having 16 and 16. So we are taking this both the 16, and then again we have to consider from C to what are remaining edges we are having. Remaining edges will be 2. So here we are having C to D or C to E we have to consider. If you are taking this part in this, here we are taken, that is D to C, or we have to consider D to E. So this we have to calculate. So now you can ask, so why we are not considered this part? Okay, so you can consider this part. Okay, but here what happened? So here that is we have to consider only the 2 things. If you are taking this part, again you have to consider this 3, and again you have to consider this 2. So it will be very lengthy process. Okay, so if you want, you can try it. Otherwise, you can give the statement to reduce the potential work. So B is visited before the C because this will be the undirected graph. Okay. So now you have to consider the value for CD, and then you have to consider the value of CE. So here 14 and 15 and 14 we are having. If you are having DC and then if you are having DE, we are having 15 and 14. Okay. So now you have to consider CD, CE. So we have to consider that is CD, CE. And then DC and DE. So DC and DE we are having. Okay. So now
here we are having 15, here we are having 15, but in this two part we are having the value 14. Okay, so now we have to consider this two. So here, that is, we are having A, B, C, E. So after E we have to go to D only. Okay, so here after E we have to consider C only, because other word notes are already visited. Okay, so now we have to consider this ED, and now we have to consider this EC. So here both the value we are having 14. So now we have visited all the vertices, so total 5 vertex we are having. So here also we have visited all the vertex, that is A, B, C, D and E. Here also A, B, C, D and E. Okay, so once you have visited all the vertex, what happened? So we have to reach to the starting vertex. So to reach to the starting vertex, we have to consider D to A. So what value we are having? And then here, that is C to A, what value we are having? So after considering this, what happened? So for this, the value we are having 16. For this, the value we are having as 14. Okay, so now compared to the 16 and 14, so 14 will be the least value. Okay, so now this will be the optimal solution for the traveling salesperson problem. So now the tour will be starts at the vertex A and passing through the vertex B to D, D to E, E to C, and finally it reached to the starting vertex, that is A. Okay, so this will be the optimal path, A to B, B to D, D to E, E to C, C to A, with the cost of 14. Okay, so now you see here the lower bound value we are having the value 14. Okay, so whatever the bound value we are having for the each and every node, so this value is not lesser than the value 14. Okay, either the value 14 we are having or it is greater than 14 we are having. Okay, so this will be the traveling salesperson problem. So traveling salesperson problem, it starts with the vertex and it visits all the vertices exactly once, and finally it reaches to the starting vertex. Okay, so here you have to find the lower bound value, because this problem will be the minimization problem. Okay, so finally we have to find the path. So if it is undirected graph, means that will be different. Okay, so depends upon the edges you have to consider the value. Okay, so now what is the difference between the backtracking and then the branch and bound? So backtracking, normally we are using, that is the DFS method. Okay, so the decision problem can be solved using the backtracking technique. So here the state space tree is searched until the solution is obtained. So till the solution is obtained, so we have to search the state space tree. Okay, so all possible solutions are tried. If solution is not satisfying the constraint, then what we have to do? Then we have to backtrack and try for the another solutions. But here we no need to backtrack in the branch and bound. Here we are using the not using the DFS. We are using, that is, the breadth first search we are using. Okay, so optimization problem can be solved using the branch and bound. So here the state space tree that needs to be searched completely. So we have to search completely the search state space tree. There may be choices of being an optimal solution anywhere in the state space tree. Okay, so in the state space tree, that we have to consider for all the choices, because the solution will be in anywhere in the state space tree. Okay, so here, that is, you see the solution is here. So if you stop here, then we won't get the proper. So we may think only the 16 will be the solution, but the actual solution will be 14. Okay, so we have to consider everything. All the possibility we have to consider to get the optimal solution in the branch and bound technique. Okay, so based on the search using the bounding value. So how we can search? So we can search using the bounding value. So if you are having the bounding value, compare the bounding values. So whichever the bounding values as the minimum bounding value, then we have to proceed in that particular node. Okay, so this will be the difference between the backtracking and branch and bound. Okay, so I have given some two examples for the particular problem. So this problem is for the assignment problem. So I am given, that is, 4 persons and I am giving the 4 jobs. So now we have to find which person is assigned to which job. Okay, and again I am giving one more problem, that is the traveling salesperson problem using the branch and bound. So what problem I explained, that will be the undirected graph. So here I am using, that is, the directed graph. So using the directed graph, how can we do the traveling salesperson problem? So here the value will not be changed. Suppose in the previous problem I told, if you are having A to B, if you are having 3, means again B to A, again we are having the value 3. Okay, so normally what happened, so frequently we will have the same value while doing this formula. Okay, but here it's not like that, the value will be different. So we have to consider it carefully. So which will be the two minimum value, and then we have to find the state space tree, and then you have to get the optimal solution for the traveling salesperson problem. Okay.